Hi there, I'm Ruben, and in this video I'll be looking at sonokinetic espressivo in detail. There are two other videos which accompany this one. If you haven't already, please watch the overview video to get a basic idea of how espressivo works. There's also a playthrough video if you just want to hear espressivo phrases in action. In this video, I'll be looking at the functions and interface of espressivo in detail. The functionality of espressivo is similar to sonokinetic's other phrase-based libraries, such as Maximo, Sotto, Grosso, and Capriccio, but there are some big differences too, so I'd recommend you stick around to find out about those. Espressivo is a phrase-based library that tempo syncs to your door. It contains string, woodwind, brass, and percussion performances that have been recorded at 130 BPM, but the phrases will be time-stretched automatically to fit your project. So this is the main interface for Espressivo, and it's split into four main parts for each of the orchestral sections, and they're color-coded. First off, click here for the interactive help menu, showing exactly what each control on the interface does. Let me explain quickly how the phrases are assigned to the keys of your keyboard. Each of the orchestral sections actually has up to three different phrases that you can play, usually low, mid, and high phrases. So looking at the strings here, you can play the low phrase on C, mid phrase on D, and high phrase on E. The little graphic here reminds you which keys are which. Woods are C sharp, D sharp, and F. Brass, G, A, and B. And percussion, F sharp, G sharp, and A sharp. So that's 12 keys in an octave. And there are four presets, so you can see those here, and therefore there's four octaves in total, and the mapping is always the same, strings on C, D, and E, on each octave as you go up the keyboard, and so on. The interface and keys are also colour-coded for easy recognition, so strings are green on the interface and on the keys, woods are blue, and so on. The presets can be selected by simply playing within that preset's octave on the keyboard, or you can click the preset number in the interface. Although you don't have to worry about that too much, just play. You can purge the samples from an individual preset field with Command Control left click on a preset number. Be aware that you cannot purge the currently selected preset. You can use this function to free up system memory. Now let's take a look at how to preview, load, and play phrases. Choose a phrase by clicking the graphic notation representing a pattern. The phrase picker window will then open. Phrases have been assigned broad categories, for example rhythmic, pads, and more melodic. You can browse them just by clicking. Each phrase has a play icon. You can click that to hear a preview of a phrase, and click again, and playback will cycle through the low, mid, and high phrases. Just click a phrase graphic to choose it, and that will load the three phrases onto the relevant keys in that preset. Sometimes there will be variations of the phrase available. These variations are derived from the original recording sessions and are usually different takes of the same kind of phrase. Click here to choose a different variation. You can also randomise the current preset. Just click the O of Espressivo. Let's hear a few of those. On the main interface, clicking one of the keyboard graphics here of each orchestral section will open the options menu for that set of phrases. Here you can adjust mod wheel, volume, panning, tuning, fade time, release tail offset, and also access the score. The small keyboard graphic at the bottom of the options window indicates which preset you're currently editing. It's also possible to go directly to the phrase picker screen by clicking the phrase graphic just here. Many of these options will be familiar to users of sonokinetic's other phrase-based libraries, and you can adjust the high, mid, and low phrases independently. So this is the control for mod wheel volume, which can be turned on or off just by clicking it. By default, it's on, so this enables you to control the volume of any phrase with the mod wheel of your keyboard. You can turn some phrases on and some off, and this is useful for changing volumes of some phrases without affecting the others. So I'll turn off mod wheel control for the high phrase and leave it on for mid and low. Now I can use the mod wheel on my keyboard to introduce volume variations in the low and mid string sections. Each phrase's individual volume can be adjusted just here. And that's the same for panning, just drag the slider left or right here. There's a tuning control for each phrase, and the range is plus or minus 2 semitones. This is handy for creating even more dissonance between phrases, and it's especially fun to assign the sliders to a MIDI controller and automate them during playback. Don't forget you can also command control and left click to reset to default. Each phrase has a release tail sample which is played when you release a key. You can adjust the offset by using these sliders, so decrease the level of the slider to begin playback further into the release samples. And you can turn off the release sample entirely by lowering a slider completely. Now onto the fade controls, and this is actually one of the most interesting aspects of Espressivo. By default, every time you hit a key, a phrase will trigger with playback from the beginning of that phrase. Let's hear it. However, using the fade sliders, you can sync the playback of one phrase to another, great for creating slowly building phrases where each phrase is introduced gradually. In addition, the phrases will be perfectly in time. Let's increase the sliders and play again. You can hear how, instead of the phrases triggering immediately as we pressed a key, they fade in slowly and are in time with the first phrase. A couple of things worth remembering here. This syncing is limited to a single preset and a single orchestral section. Also, the first phrase you play of that section will always trigger straight away, with no fade in, regardless of the fade slider setting. The next phrase or two will fade in, and the speed of that is dependent on the slider value. Here you can change the field speed relative to your host tempo, either original speed, double speed, or half speed. The default shows ITM, and this utilizes the intelligent tempo mapping setting, which will determine the most realistic and useful tempo relative to your DAW's host tempo. This will sound better with some phrases than others, also depending on the bass tempo of your composition. It's also worth mentioning that this speed control won't appear for some of the phrases, those performances that are more pad-like in nature. For any phrase, you can open the score view, which will show you the original notation. You can also open it up by clicking the middle S of Espressivo. Click on the different presets, high, mid, and low areas, and the four orchestral sections to quickly move between the various pages of the score. This notation is as accurate as it can be, but due to the nature of the material here, there will be some elements of improvisation involved. In Espressivo, the score will also update to reflect the last played phrase, so you can quickly see how each loaded phrase was conceived. Click in the outer ring here to open the microphone options. We've captured four mic positions: decatree, close, wide, and far. You can choose just one or mix two of them by setting them left and right of the slider, and the slider setting will mix the two positions. You can save CPU and RAM by just choosing one mic position, or alternatively, we've provided a set of pre-mixed patches called Espressivo Lite if your system is struggling with the full range of mic positions. Lastly, I'll mention a few things which are great time savers. You can click the inner ring here in the centre of the interface to display the quick control menu window. This window shows the most common options for adjusting the playback and functionality of the currently playing or last played phrase. This makes it easy to audition phrases and then tweak them quickly using simple controls as they're playing. If you want to reset all the parameters across the entire instrument, head to the R of Espressivo and click it with Command or Control pressed, and this will revert every parameter to default. Lastly, don't forget to click here for the interactive help menu if you get stuck. For more information about Espressivo, please take a look at the manual, check our other tutorial videos, or head to www.sonokinetic.net. For further help, you can access the Sonokinetic user area for downloads, updates, FAQs, and support, and that's at users.sonokinetic.net. Thanks so much for watching.